Be me. DM. Starting new campaign. Brand new to D&D. Playing some ungodly amalgamation of 3rd edition, 3.5 edition, and 5th edition. Be not me. Arakakri barbarian. Elven rogue. Elven wizard. And human fighter. None of us really knew how the game worked. Make shit up as we go along. First session. Making characters. Arakakri is a lying dipshit. Says he isn't using 5e but does so anyway. Too focused on campaign stuff to care. Wizard puts a lot of work into his character. Ends up playing him like a complete asshole who nobody likes. Rogue waits too long to actually give his PC any depth. Ends up as a generic rogue stereotype that kinda sits in the background. Fighter is too lazy to make new character. Steals a sheet from another campaign he was in. Thus Blethoricus was born. Party arrives in town by request of secret client. Alcoholic gnome sitting at the bar. Tells the players that he made a bunch of clockwork mages and one day they just ran off. Now they are causing trouble in the world and the gnome will pay them lots of gold to track them down and destroy them. Rogue asks how much. $1 million.jpg. Party is excited, is given a lead that one of the mages is hiding out in a mine a few towns over. Everybody buys some loot and heads out. Traveling down the road, spooky abandoned cemetery off to the side. Party decides to check it out. Walking around the graveyard when suddenly the ground bursts in front of them. Spookiscary skeletons PNG. Roll for initiative. Wizard rolls highest. Casts magic missile on one skelly boy. 7 damage. Headless skeleton now hopping around armless on one foot. Skeletons go next. Attack wizard as revenge. Wizard takes a knee to the crotch and almost downs. Barbarian smashes a skeleton with ease. Rogue runs at skeleton with fists raised. Crit fail JPG. Rogue trips on a tombstone and eats shit in front of one of the skeleton. Gets kicked in the teeth and dies. Enter Blethoricus. Swings great sword at the remaining skeleton. Nat 20.png. Skeletons are cleaved in twain. Barbarian force feeds health potion to rogue's corpse. Everyone dusts themselves off and hears whispers coming from the mausoleum. Spoopy.gif. Suicidal morons head into small chamber with unknown creature inside. I ask who's at the front of the group. Wizard blurts out me. Choker reaches down and grabs him by the throat. Lifts him into the air. Everybody freaks out. Without a word Blethoricus severs the arm. Wizard falls onto stone floor. Takes 1 damage. Dies. Everybody laughs as barbarian performs bird CPR. Head into a forest. See a house with a destitute farm ahead. Locked wrought iron gate. Rogue attempts to pick lock while Arakakra forgets he has wings. Rogue fails lock picking. About how tall is the gate? 10 feet. The bars are vertical, so you can't really climb it. I roll strength to force open the gate. 18. Fighter rips gate out of the wall. Party explores farm. See scarecrow in field. I roll to investigate the scarecrow. As Rogue was fondling the scarecrow, it animated and swiped at him. Wizard fireballs scarecrow. Nat 20. Scarecrow screams and runs across farm. Jumps down a well. Party investigates well. Kuotoa jumps out. Roll for initiative. Blethoricus rolls highest. Gives a Kuotoa a mean right hook. Kuotoa stumbles back and falls back into the well. Hear whooshing sound followed by a crack. Blethoricus cleans fish blood off of his gauntlet. Party goes to inspect house. Normal abandoned house. Crooked painting on the wall. Rogue inspects. Finds a hidden safe. Blethoricus rolls to rip safe out of the wall. Does so. But safe is still locked. Rogue picks lock. Finds diamond studded chalice inside. A quick roll reveals it to be worth thousands of gold. Wizard takes for safekeeping. Nothing more to be found in the house. Party moves on. Come upon a river with a wheelhouse on it. Wizard knocks on door. Door flies open and party is sucked inside with telekinetic ray. Inside is an Illithilich sitting in a chair sipping wine. Explains to the party he has been watching them. Offers aid in exchange for a cut of the reward. Party agrees. Is flung back out the door and across the river. Next town. Bright farming town. Sees man selling something on the street. Sly halfling selling golden apples. Promises extraordinary effects. Wizard buys one. Discovers it's just an apple wrapped in gold foil. Wizard is arrested for attempted murder on the halfling. Has to use chalice for bail. Party talks to the town. Finds out mine is under control of an orc warband. Lots of slaves. Party goes to mine. Goes down elevator. Well-lit mineshaft halls. Sounds of toil coming from room. Party checks it out. Dozens of goblin slaves mining away. Goblins explain Anetan has enslaved them. Put magical collars on their neck that explode if they try to escape. Enter debate among party about whether or not to save green midgets. Decide to come back for them after they clear out the mine. Explore mine further. Find orc guards playing knife game in break room. Party easily dispatches orcs. Blethoricus using a table as an improvised weapon. Next room PNG. Find larder full of food. Barbarian spots a trapdoor under a carpet. Further underground passage. Having not set a marching order, I assumed the wizard was still at the front of the group. Roll for perception. 4. Wizard trips over a rock and faceplants into a gelatinous cube. Blethoricus rips wizard out of the cube and slashes through the jello. Continue through the passage. Find hatch on the ceiling. Large bedroom, everything is oversized. Party searches the armoire, finds black plate armor. Blethoricus immediately puts it on. Party leaves bedroom, finds Etin King sitting at table eating an entire pig. Notices party and roars in anger. Roll for initiative. Rogue darts around Etin like a pussy. Wizard gets flattened by Morningstar. Barbarian caves in one head of the Etin. Etin is injury. Fireball.png. Rogue, barbarian, and wizard down. Blethoricus swing sword. 17. Etin now in half on the floor. Party is revived. Figures out the magical mechanism in Etin's loincloth. Goblins are freed. Party continues to elevator up to the surface. Completely forgotten about the objective. Elevator cable snaps and party plummets 4 stories. Roll for dex. Everyone passes and is not killed by fall damage. Find themselves in an open cavern. Pale blue light and distance and sound of a hammer against an anvil. Clockwork mage making sword at a forge. Pile of swords behind him. Notices party. Picks up battle axe. Roll for initiative. Fight goes on for a while. Each side taking shots. Clockwork mage casts spell turning. Wizard, not paying attention, casts chain lightning. Faith when. Everyone stares at him. DM roth.jpg. Rogue is electrocuted. Everyone else almost die. Barbarian and Blethoricus beat the shit out of the mage. Blethoricus picks up rogue fireman style and party climbs out of cavern. Next town.jpg. A port town. Rumors of a robot wizard that stole a boat and sailed off into the distance. Party tries to find a ship. Man renting boats. 500 gold per day. Blethoricus rolls for persuasion to try to lower the price. Record scratch.wow. Black plate armor is cursed. Reduces charisma score to 4. Add that on top of the terrible roll. Blethoricus utters a series of Neanderthal-esque growls and grunts. Boat guy is confused. Player uses this to advantage. Rolls for intimidation. 20. Blethoricus channels the spirit of the headless clone of Spiro Agnew and snarls menacingly. Salesman gives boat for free. Party sets sail. Middle of the night, hired captain screams in terror. Party rouses themselves. Blethoricus still wearing armor. Draug a ship in the distance. Blethoricus throws brick of unknown origin at Viking zombies. They are unaffected. Draug a quickly board party's boat. Roll for initiative. Blethoricus throws another brick and decapitates a Draugr. I ask the player out of character where he got the bricks. He says that Blethoricus always carries a bag of holding filled with bricks. Fuck it.png. Blethoricus sits in the bag, hucking bricks at Draugr. Wizard gets grappled by undead captain. Blows strength roll and has to add 3 elven pussiness on top of that. Chucked overboard. Manages to catch himself on the ledge with one hand. Draugr cackle with Norse vigor and walk over with axes raised. They continue to fail to attempt to chop wizard's hand off. Blethoricus charges and body checks one of the Draugr. Kraplunk.mp3. Wizard is saved and party continues their voyage. Arrive in token desert biome. Find residence in town carved into the side of a cliff, populated entirely by outcast satyrs. Party heals up and buys new loot. Hear that clockwork mage mind raped some people and brought them to an old pyramid. They went that away.jpg. Party heads to the pyramid through canyon. Canyon is called Cobbled Canyon. Party doesn't question it. A couple random encounters later and they end up in a larger area. Random stone pillars all over. Trap.jpg. Kobolds pop up and start throwing rocks. Arakakra flies up and grabs one, spiking it to the ground like a touchdown. Kobolds combine their weakling strength and attempt to pull over one of the pillars onto the party. It falls. Party rolls for dex. Everyone makes it except Blethoricus. Keep in mind, up until this point, Blethoricus hasn't died. Proceeds to get pulverized by stone pillar. Party finishes kobolds off, revives Blethoricus for the first time. Blethoricus is thoroughly shook by his experience. Petrophobia.jpg. Party then wades through sandy desert to pyramid. They enter the pyramid, encounter giant spider. Takes an inordinate amount of time to kill this CR1 spider. Travel down. As it turns out, pyramid is almost completely buried in sand. Hear pickaxe sounds from chamber. Party inspects. Find 6 more kobolds robbing a grave. Blethoricus activates Tug Rage and brutally eviscerates dragon midgets. Find some loot and continue down the pyramid. Mostly empty chamber with only a few statues. Wizard inspects them. Animateobject.gif. Statues come alive and attack. Roll initiative. Statues win despite terrible dex. Pummel Blethoricus with stone fists. Blethoricus cowers in fear. Petrophobia 2 Electric Boogaloo.png. Barbarian smashes statues and helps Blethoricus out of his PTSD flashbacks. Next level, 4 sarcophagi, one in each corner of the room, surrounded by boatloads of treasure. Greedy bastard wizard tries to steal a piece. All sarcophagi open and mummies come out. One grabs the rogue with his wrappings and slams him against the walls. Barbarian skewers one with his holy trident. Wizard almost kills everyone again by casting fireball in such a closed area. Nevertheless, mummies are dead. Party scrapes loot into treasure storage pocket dimension. Here's sounds of battle one level below. Everybody hurries down to see. Dominated satyrs fighting in pit. Clockwork mage sitting on giant throne. Surrounded by more thralls. Notices party. Sends mind slaves after them. I meant this to be an interesting opportunity for non-fatal combat. Lol no PNG. Party brutally murders innocent satyrs. They scale the throne and beat the mage's clockwork ass. With one last tick, the mage presses a button on his throne. Giant air machines on the side of the room creak to life. Sand bubbling. Giant mummified octopus emerges from the sand. Thafuk wow. Party surprised. Sandopus goes first. Drags barbarian under the sand. You about to drown in sand. Wizard and rogue climb onto the ceiling like lil bitches. Blethoricus majestically swan dives into the sand. Wrestles Sandopus. After multiple rounds of spells being cast from the ceiling, barbarian screeching like an autist, and Blethoricus methodically ripping tentacles off of the monster, Sandopus dies. Before the body sinks, a scroll case flies out of its corpse. Rogue catches it midair and opens it. Scroll.jpg. Party decides the world can wait. Side quest time, bitches. Party loots all of the dead bodies and heads out of the pyramid. Following the map, they find themselves at the mouth of a cave in a mountain. They go in. Cave mouth was an illusion. Inside is actually an exquisite mansion. Giant empty tube inside. Party says fuck it and they all make their way up the tube via various different means. Level 2. They see a magical harpsichord playing itself. Deck of cards on a pedestal. Wizard draws a card. Dragon appears in front of them. Party's face when rogue throws self over balcony. Party realizes it's an illusion. Everyone laughs at rogue. Wizard pockets deck of illusions. They fly up one more level and see a grand hall filled with petrified humanoids and a beholder sleeping at the end. Rogue is shoehorned into attempting to assassinate the fucker. Blows stealth roll. Beholder wakes up. Rogue narrowly dodges death ray. Roll initiative. Blethoricus charges ahead and removes multiple ice stalks. Beholder is pissed. Telekinesis rays Blethoricus over the balcony. Stabs sword into the wall. Stops falling. Wizard is sad because he can't cast any spells. Pouts in corner for his turn. Barbarian beats Beholder with mace. The Beholder looks past him and disintegrates Wizard. At this point Blethoricus has made it back up. Flings shield like Captain America. Slices the rest of the ice stalks off of the Beholder. Rogue and Barbarian dogpile Beholder. Barbarian shatters its skull and rogue stabs eye out. Beholder flops to ground and rolls away. Party summons a Lithilich for the first time to reintegrate Wizard. Proceed to ransack Beholder's house and exit through the back. Go into jungle. Giant ass Sturgis flying around. Blathoricus grabs one out of midair and crushes it with his bare hands. Entire party drenched in blood. Also notices that the river flowing through the jungle is actually blood. Spoopy.png. Find native tribe. Elder talks about giant blood demon living deep in the jungle. River is Runoff sacrifices to him. Party buys medicine in case of airborne syphilis and moves ahead. Overgrown temple. Dostuck. Rogue can't pick lock. Blathoricus removes the rock from around the door. Door is cast aside and party peers inside. Multiple chitons torturing a man, preparing to extract all his blood with giant syringe mounted on the ceiling. Blathoricus charges ahead and beats one of the chitons with his fists. Rest of party advances and attacks. Chitons focus on Blathoricus and attempt to restrain him with chains. Blathoricus breaks free with ease, cuts one chiton in half. Other two try to flee. Blathoricus rips syringe off of roof and hurls it like a javelin. 20. One chitin impaled through the back of his chest and pinned to the wall. Other one slips away. Party frees man and lets him wander away alone, presumably to get eaten by Sturgis for all of his delicious blood. See chitin running across a bridge over a chasm. Air is thick with the stench of iron and death. Party books it across bridge and enters a clearing. Sees chitin talking with stone statue. Statue animates. Forearms, leaking blood from its joints. Wizard makes an int check. It's a type of demon called a Moxix. Moxix is pissed, rips chitin in half like pick related. Party spooked. Blathoricus seething with rage. Petrophobia part 3. Moth. Blathoricus charges in and screams with reckless abandon. Gets backhanded and lands back by the party. Moxix chuckles. Red storm clouds form. Lake of blood rises up in the clearing. Stone columns thrust out of the ground. Roll for initiative. Melee characters attack. Barbarian does fuckhole. Blathoricus slices leg with battle axe. 80 gallons of blood flies out at 300c. Blathoricus stands firm. Weapon flies out of his hands like a grease cucumber. Wizard casts fireball. Forgets that demons are immune to fire. HFW. Rogue attempts to dive at the Moxix with his katana he stole from the beholder. Filthy weeb. 1. Sails past Moxix. Ends up in the lake of blood and contracts god knows how many STDs. Moxix picks up stone column. Wielding it like a club, he splashes it into the lake. Rogue is flattened. Blathoricus has an idea. I wanna try to pick up a stone pillar. Entire table looks at him like he's retarded. Roll for athletics. 20. With great ease, Blathoricus swings a pillar onto his back. Make him move at half speed. We would later find out after some math that the pillar would have weighed 6,000 pounds. Blathoricus trudges over to Moxix. Takes two turns. In the interim, Barbarian keeps Moxix occupied. Blathoricus shoves pillar into Moxix's knee. Oof.png. Moxix screams. Blathoricus runs over to another pillar. Moxix takes out frustration on closest living thing. It's the wizard. Moxix grabs him and breathes stanky demon breath into his face. Wizard's pupils dilate. Turns into ravenous ghoul. Hops down and takes off after Blathoricus, who is casually drinking a health potion while carrying the pillar. Wizard ghoul attacks. 1. Wizard ghoul smacks into Blathoricus like a retard in a rubber room. Falls unconscious. Moxix, having pummeled the barbarian into the dirt, turns to see a clanking suit of armor carrying another pillar. He wasn't having any more of that shit. Rips pillar out of the ground. Duels Blathoricus with pillars. Blathoricus knocks weapon out of Moxix's hand. Oh fuck.jpg. Moxix gets fucking brained by Blathoricus. Body stumbles back into the lake of blood. Rain clouds go away. Blood recede. Blathoricus revives everybody. Entire party looking like they climbed inside a giant's gooch when it was on its period. Everybody is disappointed when they hear there is no loot, except Blathoricus. A close listen revealed a hissing sound coming from his helmet. Party goes back to Sataville to rest up. Next day, party embarks on another boat they practically stole. Sailing to Token Ice Biome, comes across an island, heavily populated. While on the island, Blathoricus buys a blunderbuss and 500 rounds of ammunition. Proceeds to tie it to the handle of his battle axe. Economy leans on Colosseum on a cliff. Party says fuck it and signs up. Grand prize is a villa on the coast. Entire party pumped as hell. Brought into arena. Weird gnome guy announcing. Turns out using regular criminals got too boring. Arena is now a deathmatch between humanoids and various golems. First enemy. Iron Golem. Party dispatches it with no issue. Second enemy. Mithril Golem. Can make itself liquid or any form it wants. T-1000.gif. Shanks Rogue and Barbarian. Wizard freezes it with Cone of Cold. Blathoricus shatters it with his fists. Third enemy. Clockwork Golem. Platrelevancy.jpg. Writhing mass of gears lurches towards party. Rogue rolls to cut it with his precious katana. 1. Katana is shredded and spat out the other side of the golem. Face when. Blathoricus makes quick work of the golem with his blunderbuss. Fourth and final enemy. Huge iron golem. Furnace burning in its chest. Nicknamed Bruno by the owners. Bruno charges Blathoricus. Clearly recognizes biggest threat. Stuffs Blathoricus inside the furnace. Blathoricus is indifferent. Hangs out for a few rounds. Barbarian goes to attack. 37 damage. Bruno is pissed. Swats Barbarian to the ground. Smashes with hand. Cannon comes out of Bruno's torso and replaces his head. Fires at his own hand. Chicken panini PNG. Barbarian flattened. Rogue gets fisted. Jiggity.gif. Blathoricus finishes his sauna time, wrenches bars open, climbs up Bruno's chest, rips head off, fires blunderbuss multiple times into the hole. Bruno crashes down to the ground. Blathoricus is crowned winner, receives deed to the villa, gathers up party and rests for a night. Rogue and Barbarian couldn't make it the rest of the sessions. Explain it as them working off gambling debts after betting on themselves killing the golem. Now it is just Blathoricus and Tardamancer. Set sail for Iceland. Arrive a few days later. Cole.jpg. Ice Town. Go to tavern to ask about their mission. Blathoricus converses with natives. Wizard cheats some people in a game and pisses them off. Almost gets his ass kicked. Blathoricus, having developed the vaguest sense of pity for wizard, reaches over and grabs a thug by the neck. His friend, presumably drunk, punches Blathoricus in the helmet and almost breaks his hand. This captures the attention of a burly man sitting at the bar. Basically a Spanish Gaston that isn't a dick. Named Fernando. Situation escalates. Man attempts to use bar mug as weapon against wizard. Succeeds. Wizard clocked in the face by tankard of ale. Barfight.jpg. Fernando bounds off of a bar stool and elbow drops himself into the fray. Wizard turns invisible like a pussy. Blathoricus picks a man up and throws him down the bar. Uses wizard's invisible body as a weapon. Blathoricus is now flailing around autistically and people 4 feet away are getting knocked down. Fight continues for some time. Bartender eventually pulls out a blunderbuss and fires it in the air. Orders everyone out. Blathoricus politely cleans himself off. Picks up wizard and exits the building. Meets up with Fernando. A kindred spirit. He and Blathoricus pontificate at length about their many battles. Blathoricus explains his mission, notices that sword has disappeared. Must have been taken in the fray. Blathoricus is angry, but realizes he can't do anything about it. For now, Fernando tells him about a blacksmith that works out of a lighthouse on the coast. Gives a glowing recommendation. Blathoricus and a heavily bruised and battered wizard head to the lighthouse. Gives a door too slow knock. Door opens. Lady Tiefling in blacksmith garb appears. Blathoricus finds himself interested in something that isn't brutally murdering something. Blacksmith introduces herself. Name of Morgana. Invites them in. Blathoricus bumbles his way through some basic RP roles. Wizard has to do most of the explaining. Morgana invites pair to dinner. Blathoricus and wizard enjoy first home-cooked meal of the adventure. Freshly caught ice squid. Still wriggling on the plate, wizard makes retarded remark, can't remember the specific, but it was bad enough to be of mention. Blathoricus counters with a polite compliment about the food. Suddenly the ground starts to shake. Red light fills the room. Smell of brimstone seeps into Blathoricus' helmet. Devil clad in regal red robes steps through a portal. Morgana panics. Oh my god, dad, get the fuck out. Dad.png. Dad is offended. Asks to be introduced to her friends. Wizard makes another dumbass remark, slips through portal in the floor, reappears in the corner with white hair and dilated pupils. Blathoricus genially introduces himself. Dad takes liking to Blathoricus. Creates him a new weapon. Blathoricus doesn't question how he knows he needed a new weapon. a deep red warhammer with a pentagram carved in the head. Blathoricus compliments the craftsmanship. Dad stays for dinner and eats his squid. Says farewell and goes back through a portal. Morgana invites Blathoricus into her bedroom to see her personal collection. Adult activities ensue. Blathoricus removes armor for first time in 15 years. Leaves helmet on. Wizard still catatonic in the corner of the kitchen. Next morning. Blathoricus puts armor back on. Says farewell. Picks up wizard. Slaps him in the face with all of his virile might. Wizard returns to normal. Hears rumors of a monastery harboring two clockwork mages. 300 miles into the frozen desert. Apparently most convenient mode of transport is ice skiff, basically flying boat. Just so happens Fernando has one, rents for free. Off into the distance flies the ice skiff. A few hours later, Wizard is steering. This would later prove to be a fatal mistake. Blathoricus sees fleet of ice skiffs in the distance behind them. Orc bandits chasing after them, screaming about a bounty or some shit. Two pull up to each side, one in the back. Orcs board Blathoricus ice skiff. Critical error.png. Orcs are end of their flesh. Wizard isn't retarded for once and lightning bolts a skiff, taking it down. Blathoricus finishes off the skiff on the side by throwing a brick into its engine. Throwback Thursday.jpg. Skiff to the rear pulls up to the right. Orc leader laughing and prepares to board, is hit by harpoon midair. What.png. Shark man on larger skiff roars ahead. Yanks the orc onto his skiff and throws him into a meat grinder on the back. Wizard makes a check. Race of savage shark people called Salakians. Shark guy hurls harpoon. Actually manages to penetrate Blathoricus's armor. Roll for strength contest. Player smiles. Throws dice. 16. Plus 5 is 21. I roll. 8. Salakian ripped off of his skiff and onto Blathoricus's. Battle ensues. Retard wizard casts darkness for some reason. Dark PNG. Blathoricus and Salakian swing wildly around in the dark. Blathoricus lands it. Salakian stumbles back and scream. Fell off like a moron. Wizard celebrates and ends darkness. 20 feet in front of a glacier. Oshidjif. Skiff crashes. Blathoricus is angry. Wizard feels like a moron. With good reason. Have to walk the rest of the way on foot. Trudging through snow. Ice begins to rumble. Adult Remor has bursts through the ice. Wizard shits pants. Blathoricus is in no mood. Claps Remor has his head between hands. 20. Head explodes. Blathoricus and Wizard are showered in dark green blood. Remor has carcass keeps them warm for a while. Eventually show up at monastery. Blathoricus is tired. Bangs very hard on door. Old monk with hazy purple eyes opens door. Blathoricus demands shelter. Monk kindly obliges. Wizard immediately passes out from exhaustion. Blathoricus cleans armor and goes to sleep. In the middle of the night, Blathoricus is awoken. Sounds of strange chanting in another room. A not terrible int roll reveals it as Abyssal. Blathoricus seethes with rage. There are two things that Blathoricus distinctly hates. Rocks, and demons. He barges into the room. Runes written in blood on the wall. Monks wearing hoods and holding a corpse. Blathoricus brutalizes them all with great efficiency. After the massacre, footsteps are heard outside. Blathoricus stuffs all the corpses into a pillowcase. Monk headmaster enters room, demands explanation. Blathoricus explains that they were trying to summon demons. Monk pauses for a minute. What if you were trying to summon demons? Reverse JPG. Blathoricus sees past the Indian tech support ruse. Swings Elhammer. It impacts a monk with an explosion of magic. After the smoke settled, it was not one, but two clockwork mages. They ran to the center of the monastery and up to an altar. A demonic rite is performed and a portal to the abyss opens. Mages use magic mouth to cackle maniacally. Blathoricus sees outline of Demogorgon in the portal. Readies hammer. Runs up and beats mages into dust before they can react. Steals the magic part of their body. The portal is closed. Everything is silent. Blathoricus investigates more. Finds Direwolf puppy chained in basement. He intimidates the ferality out of it. It is now his companion. Asmodeus appears behind him. Almost frightened Blathoricus. Almost. Nice work killing those demon fags. Blathoricus nods soberly. So hey, listen, you got my daughter pregnant. Actually frightened Blathoricus. So here's the deal. You come to Avernus right now and get married to my daughter, or I turn you into a lemur tasked with emptying out Beelzebul's lavatory for the next eternity or so. Blethoricus nods with purpose. Excellent. Let's go. Portal appears under monastery. Entire building falls to hell. Blethoricus.jpg. Monastery lands in the streets of Avernus. Asmodeus vanishes. Blethoricus is immediately attended to by multiple bone devils who escort him off to a dressing room. Take off the armor. Blethoricus lets loose a string of vulgarities at the devil. Devils show restraint under threat of demotion. Here, we won't look. Just take this and put it on. Blethoricus is handed a gray uniform and boots. Begrudgingly changes into new clothes. Keeps helmet on. Handsome Blethoricus PNG. Where did you get this? I've never seen any uniform like this before. We got it off of some blonde cuck who got sent here. Name was Fritz or some shit like that. Asmodeus reappears. Blethoricus asks where the church is. We're already there. What the fuck? Blethoricus turns around to see him standing at the altar of a devil church. Different archdevils sitting in front pew. Blethoricus turns around to see the officiant. Officiant.jpg. Feels rumbling in the ground. Devils don't seem to feel it. Morgana begins down the aisle. Seated on a howdah carried by bearded devil. Rumbling more noticeable. Devils notice it this time. Wall crashes down. Three clockwork mages standing there. Meteor swarm crashing down in the distance. Archdevils charge them. Magic circle bitches. Center mage pulls out sledgehammer. Other mages faces when. Center mage smashes both mages. Steals their magic shit. Grows 200 feet. Blethoricus charges. Gets knocked back by giant hand. Giant mage casts negative energy flood. Half of the patrons become zombies. Morgana buried by rubble. Blethoricus's face when. Tard rage activated. Mind you, by this point I had stopped caring about roles and just let players do whatever they wanted. Leaps over horde of zombies. Lands on mage's chest. Makes himself an entrance with his axe. Climbs inside. Mage doesn't seem to notice. Blethoricus empties bag o' bricks into the gears. Crunch.mp3. Mage is now aware of what is happening. Falls to its knees. Blethoricus climbs through the torso of the mage and out of its shoulder. Mage swats at him. Blethoricus grabs hand. Mage now frantically tries shake Blethoricus off of itself. Blethoricus carries the momentum of the hand into a jump and flings himself at the eye of the mage. Makes another entrance with his blunderbuss. Now inside the head of the mage. Blethoricus begins dismantling gearboxes with his bare hands. Mage now literally grinding to a halt. Finds magic gem at the center of the head. Blethoricus starts tearing it out with his bare hands, slowly crushing it. Gem reaches critical mass. Explodes like a neutron star. Mage is almost entirely disintegrated. Blethoricus is fine. Plotarmor.jpg. Zombies are gone. Asmodeus is staggering about like a drunk. Blethoricus sees gloved hand under rocks, rushes over to it. Tosses rocks aside. Morgana lying dead. A single tear falls out of the helmet. Blethoricus screams with rage. Blazing blue light crackles in the air. Divine figure of Tempus, god of war, appears. Looks down upon Blethoricus. My son, you have been unjustly wrought this punishment, have you not? Blethoricus unleashes roar of anguish. Tempus smiles. To the victor go the spoil. Blethoricus wails again. Tempus disappears. Morgana wakes with a cough. Blethoricus, breaking the laws of basic logic, screams so loud and so prolonged he passes out. Days later, Blethoricus wakes up in a bed, helmet still on. Morgana sitting peacefully in a chair, smiles and greets her husband. Husband, the officiant married us while you were still unconscious. You apparently let out a grunt that sounds like I do, so he went with it. Blethoricus smiles, takes a deep breath, removes his helmet. So I've recently moved Icbeardia merch over to Teesprings and have a few new designs. Listings are below the video and in the description. So I am an affiliate of NordVPN. If you have been thinking of getting a VPN, with everything going on at the minute, NordVPN is offering 75% off a 3-year plan. I have been using Nord myself for a few years now because it helps support a lot of the people I like to watch on YouTube, and I think it's pretty cool they have let me become an affiliate. So check out nordvpn.org/nickbeardia and use coupon code nickbeardia for 75% off while the offer is on.
Just stop. Just stop it. Stop. No. Just stop it. It's time to stop. It's time to stop, okay? No more. Where the fuck are your parents? Who are your parents? I'm gonna call Child Protective Services. It's time to stop.